Hello, welcome to the beginning of Deuce EX Human Revolution Director's Cut. I don't intend to actually play through this game again. But the new one comes out tomorrow, and I kind of want to play it. And because of it, I am going to just play a little bit of the beginning of it, just to remind myself on what type of game this is. So I'm gonna go tell me a story, because in the regular one, I'll probably play on normal mode, because, you know, gotta play in normal mode. You also notice I have this weird thing.
Is everything in place?
Almost.
What do you mean, almost?
I have spoken with Montreal. The broadcast satellites are ours when we need them. A few weeks of discomfort and the public will be primed for our recall.
And the clinics?
We control the birth rate. They will do as we say.
I still think we should wait for the referendum.
We can't afford to wait. America's Science Board convenes next month.
But the mood among the delegates is shifting. I'm positive that given more time...
No. By going public with this discovery, Seraph is forcing our hand.
Change overnight just because David Seraph willed it.
Besides,
we can do nothing until our biochip is ready.
I thought you said you were close.
Finding the correct nerve interface has proven more challenging than anticipated. Fortunately, thanks to David, I now know where to look.
And in Washington tonight, crowds continue to gather in front of the Capitol. Most are demanding that Congress severely restrict efforts to alter the human body's abilities. This in response to claims made by biotechnology expert David Seraph that his firm may have discovered a way to make human-controlled evolution available to all. Seraph Industries researchers are set to arrive in Washington tomorrow to defend their claim. But for tonight, this is Eliza Kazan.
With all due respect, Major, I'll expect two security details waiting for us, on the tarmac. No, we won't be going through the terminal, it's too exposed. Yes. I'm glad you understand. Good night, idiot.
Something wrong?
No, not for me, it isn't. But you keep pulling on that necklace, Dr. Reed, and you're gonna break it. Come on, Meg. You've defended your research before.
That was different. Then it was all just theories. But this discovery, Adam? It's big. Kepler big. Rosetta Stone big.
So, what's the problem?
They'll want to know how I found it.
Megan, we're leaving for DC and... Adam, you're there. Good.
You need something, boss?
Yeah. I want to go over your security plans for Washington before we leave. You and your team ready to go, Megan?
Almost, David. We're just rechecking data.
Well, make it snappy. We have to actually be in Washington before you can dazzle all those federally appointed know-it-alls.
I hate it when he does that. Come on, I'll walk you partway.
So, this is actually, I don't know if this is a good idea, because so there's a couple of new things that I'm doing. One of the ones is that I'm actually recording this at 4K 30 FPS, and the reason why is because I'm kind of testing a new type of way to record my games as well. However, it doesn't seem to be going really well at the moment. But pretty much is to upscale them to 4K, even if I'm playing them at like a lower resolution. And speaking of which, let's go into the options really quick and I'll show you what that is. Additionally, you may notice that my webcam stuff is kind of weird. I'm still tinkering with this for the game that I'm going to play probably tomorrow. So, you know, I'm sure it'll be a better way, hopefully. If it isn't, you already know what I look like, so. Display options are pretty much this. So resolution, I'm recording this at 1080p, but the stream is at 720p. Refresh rate, aspect ratio, full screen. And this is a 3D option, which I'm not using. Advanced settings, everything is kind of maxed. DirectX 11 and anti-aliasing is all the way up, as you can see. Theodos is all the way up. Depth of field all the way up. SSAO all the way up. Yeah, blah, 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 blah. And that's it for those options in audio. It's just music, dialogue, SFX, subtitles, and that's it. Controls, you already know about the controls. Difficulty, yes, you already know. Going with tell me a story. And that's it. You can get an achievement.
Patient X.
That's nothing, Adam. Just some of the research. Look, we really have to go.
If you look through these, you would basically see, like, DNA analysis of sample taken shows unusually high presence of mutagenic chemicals in the primary
strand.
Please,
Adam, I'm nervous enough.
Okay. I will, so when I play the other game, I'll read through small stuff like this. And you could basically look through a lot of them here. Let's see.
You still have this?
It was a gift from our first date.
It was a spur-of-the-moment purchase. A joke.
Well, it worked, because I forgave you for picking me up in one of those. Be careful with that. It's a first edition. David bought it for me. Are you coming?
In a second.
So we're headed towards Washington. So, augmentation is actually a pretty...
thought women were the ones who kept men waiting.
Interesting field of study.
You know, you really should get in the habit of locking your computer, Meg.
I know. Frank gets on me about it, too.
Emails.
Hey! Stop reading my emails.
I'm sorry.
Wow. How long ago was this taken?
In grad school. Before I met you.
Back when you were hobnobbing with the rich and famous, I see. I wonder if Mr. Darrow remembers you.
God, I hope not.
Okay. So let me actually just bring that up really quick so you know what I'm talking about. So there is this new discovery in, I believe it's chemical engineering, where they actually take off strands of DNA and see what type of mutations people have and all this stuff. And this is a very recent one. Clustered regularly interspace short palindromic repeats. So pretty much this allows them to study different things and create new experiments much faster than they had before. So an experiment that would have taken 1 year will be reduced down to like 2 months or 3 months or 1 month, you know, and they're still modifying it. So if this works the way they intended to, we'll pretty much be where we'll be in another revolution where we can augment ourselves and make ourselves much, much better. So
David's waiting out.
So what you're seeing here is not far off from what could happen in our lifetime, which is very fascinating to me. So, all right.
Warning. This lab is for authorized personnel only.
What did you mean back there, Meg? About how you found it?
Nothing. It's just my nerves talking.
There's something I should know about this place, about Seraph.
Megan!
Hold on.
We're still getting biochemical fluctuations across the artificial flow cells.
Okay, but the increased neural peptides coming from the PDOT cluster could be throwing off your calibrations.
Right, I'll double check that.
I can't believe you were asking about David. You've been here long enough to know of... Eric, you wouldn't be avoiding me, would you?
I wouldn't dream of it, Dr. Reed. I think I know why Deccan's readings are off.
Too many peptides?
I'm thinking the glial tissue breakdown we noticed after splicing in the repressive protein might be the cause. If we had a better cytometer...
We might get a more accurate reading.
Visitors must be accompanied.
I'll ask David to consider it.
Well, if he orders one from Page Industries, maybe they'll throw in another cappuccino maker.
You overthink everything, Adam. The work we're doing is good. We're helping people overcome their physical limitations.
Yeah, except most of our clients seem to be DOD.
You're doing
it's
good.
It's not all
just another hour to go.
We work with teachers, doctors, construction workers.
Oh. Damn it!
Watch it, Eddie. Those boxes are worth more than your salary.
Sorry.
Nia, you almost ready?
For Washington? Huh.
Ah, Dr. Reed. This is General O'Neill.
Dr. Savchenko was telling me you've made progress on the typhoon.
Yes. Thanks to Vasily, actually.
As I was saying, sir, the Typhoon uses a modified combat chassis like the one I'm wearing. But I've improved its design using shaped microchargers to propel the steel balls.
And the backblast problem?
Solved through kinetic bleeders in the augment. Here, watch. Go ahead.
How soon till it's ready?
I'm afraid I have to run, but Vasily has all the details, General.
Of course.
We still have some work to do to improve the time.
You're right. The teacher would just love having one of those things.
You're missing the point. Defense contracts keep us afloat, but neural augmentations that make you think faster, react quicker, they can really improve a life. Everybody's lives. David's talked about it for years.
Yeah. He is a talker.
He's a good man. Admit it, Adam. A part of you likes him.
I like everyone, Dr. Reed.
Yeah, right.
I'll talk more about Sismo.
Diane's office. I forgot to leave her a key so she can walk Kubrick. He's gotten big, you know. Keeps knocking over all my plants.
Did you destroy that vase yet?
I moved it. And I fenced in the yard. Like you always said you were going to.
Yeah. Never got around to that. Sorry.
Me too. About a lot of things. Adam, there's something I...
Good evening.
Pritchard.
So, are we all ready for the trip?
There's Farida. I'd better hurry. See you at the helipad, Adam.
Sure.
Did I interrupt something, Jensen?
You fixed that firewall yet?
You don't fix an entire firewall. You find the loophole and plug it.
Then did you plug it?
Yes, I did. Want to know how? Oh, wait, I forgot. Ex-cop. I doubt you'd understand.
Ex-SWAT, and you'd be surprised. Seraph has to see you too.
Athena. She wants me to show her how to track our scientist-implanted locator devices. In case your security plans in Washington don't measure up.
They will.
Gentlemen, how wonderful to see you both. Go right in, Adam. He's waiting.
This is the newest in encrypted GPL trackers, Athena. It transmits data to our dedicated satellites every 10 feet.
I don't care what it takes. I want Hugh Darrow in Washington by my side.
The man doesn't jump for anyone. He's a Nobel Prize winner.
Senators love this guy, Lyle. The hearings will go much smoother with him there. Big day for us tomorrow. Everything in place?
Yes, sir. Capitol Police will escort us to the Hill, and then Federal Protection Services takes over.
Good. How's our girl holding up?
She's nervous.
All she has to do is show him her research. She explained it to you?
Not really into the whole science thing, boss.
It's incredible. All those purists out there accusing us of tampering with the natural order. When all Megan's done is figure out how to unlock the potential that exists within our own DNA. It's safer and easier than anything you, Darrow, ever did.
Environmental malfunction. Laboratory subsection 6. All lab chiefs, please report in.
We better not take any chances. Not tonight. Use my elevator to get down there. You know the code?
Yeah, 0451.
Let me know what you find. Athena, get someone to shut off the damn racket.
Yes, sir.
Pritchard, where's Megan? She report in yet?
Her GPL implant shows her moving through the microchem labs. I think she's running.
Damn. Must have been a serious equipment failure. Can you get eyes on her?
I'm trying, but the intellicams aren't responding. There's interference coming from somewhere. Find out what's happening, Jensen. Hurry!
Pritchard? Pritchard!
Before you can do anything, you must be able to get around. The first move you'll want to learn is the crouch.
Wow, that's so helpful.
It will allow you to get into small spaces, such as air vents, or to hide behind low objects so you can move about unnoticed.
No way.
Jumping on objects or ladders is essential for getting to those hard-to-reach places. Sometimes going high or low is not enough. Sometimes you just need to go fast. You'll only be able to sprint for a few seconds at a time, though, so use it wisely.
Okay. Wow, very helpful hints. Jump, crouch, move around. Fantastic. So this is one of those games where you don't have to attack anybody and you're fine. I'm gonna try not to attack anybody, but no promises. I'm right here. Look at me. No? All right. You can move out of it by pressing the E button. Okay. Didn't expect that. That's cool. All right. This might be interesting.
When the lead starts to fly, it's wise to take cover. This will protect you from bullets and explosives. To shoot, peek out from behind your cover spot. Either to the side or from above. Then take aim and fire. Whenever possible, use cover when moving around. Line of sight is important. And by keeping behind cover, you'll stand a better chance that enemies won't get a bead on you.
Won't get a bead on you, huh? Isn't it won't get a jump on you? You're in this room. I don't actually know how to get in cover, honestly. That's a mistake. Thank you.
someone hiding over there?
No.
Hostile in the area! Pirates!
You runner?
I see you!
Where is your hostile?
Close the door. Screw it. I'm out. Oh, wrong way. Gotta run for it. You guys can't kill. Alright, never mind. Give me one sec. Yeah, I don't think that I can do the 4K stuff yet, so I'm gonna have to wait for that. Whenever that comes. It's gonna be a while. Cause I don't think I'll be able to get like a CPU like a game and stuff. Oh, I must have lagged there. Sorry about that. Nothing I can do about it. I think this was a good plan. I just messed up because of that extra enemy that just showed up.
Enough people today.
sorry.
Good intro. It's been a while since I've seen it.
David, you in the building?
Just entered the lobby.
Sorry to pull you out of sick leave so soon, but we've got a situation. A break-in at our Milwaukee Junction factory. Meet me at the helipad.
I have to see Pritchard first. Something's wrong with my retinal enhancement.
Frank's on the second floor in the tech lab. Make it quick. People's lives are at stake.
It's been tough on everyone these past few months.
Hey, I remember. Wow, it was pretty close to it. I don't know that. Maybe I don't remember. Is this Pritchard? Are you Pritchard? Oh, there. Am I at the wrong place? Sure seems like it. Maybe you have to go over here. No. But it says I'm right here, so I don't understand.
I can't believe this. Why the hell is anyone attacking us? Do we even know who these guys are yet?
I don't know. What are you talking about, man? Maybe I need to go find a way to go upstairs or something. No, it doesn't seem like it. Oh, second floor, okay. That's why.
Why is David keeping the SWAT team from going in right away? Doesn't he remember the last attack?
You can't compare the two. Those guys were obviously military. These ones are jazz.
About time. What happened? You get stuck in an air duct on the way over?
Yeah, nice to see you too, Francis. Something's wrong with my retinal display. Can you fix it?
If it's what I think it is, probably. Of course, it might seem.
Looks like your left and right imaging processors weren't completely in sync.
But don't worry. Your Sentinel health implant will kick in soon, repairing any damage that might have caused. Your retinal display should be fine now. Its recognition software won't be picking up hostiles yet, but you should be seeing radar and targeting reticules. Biomedical data too, if you're in pain.
Right. We done here? Because Seraph is waiting for me at the helipad.
I know. Radicals have broken into our manufacturing plant and taken hostages.
Maybe this time you'll actually save people.
If you got a problem with me, Pritchard, why don't you just say it and get it over with?
Why no, Jensen. I don't have a problem with you. If anything, I blame myself.
The mighty Pritchard blaming himself. That's gotta be a first.
I'm the one who told Seraph we needed a physical security team to protect us.
if he'd read my report closely enough.
Wait a second. Are you saying it was your idea to hire me?
Not you, Jensen. I wanted Dynacor, Sharp Edge, or Bell Tower. All the top private security contractors were on my list, but Sarif wanted somebody in-house. And so did Dr. Reed.
I suggest you leave Megan out of this.
Why, Jensen? It's no secret how close the two of you were. And let's face it, you'd just been fired from SWAT for that massacre in Mexican Town. No one was about to hire you.
You really have to stop getting your news from those Pikus blogs, Francis. They only confuse you.
The point is, if Sarif had listened to me, we wouldn't be having this conversation. But Megan, God love her, always did have Sarif's ear.
Sarif's ear is going to be hearing a report about violence in the workplace if you keep this up. You really feel like continuing?
Point taken.
Okay, great. If I were to play this, like, for real, I guess, I would choose the other option instead of the one that you know, that causes commotion. A lot more to read, so that's cool.
Well, look at this. Finally decided to get off your ass, Adam. Glad to see it. For a while there, I thought you'd never walk again.
Thanks, man.
Adam, how close are you to the helipad?
Almost there.
Good. Because SWAT's about to turn this into a PR nightmare. Meet me in the chopper. I'll brief you as we go.
So.
Welcome back, Jensen. Didn't think we'd see you around here for a while yet.
You know how it goes, Malik. Duty calls.
Don't I know it? I was in my wingsuit halfway to the top of the Renaissance Center when I got the 911. But you? 6 months is a hell of a short time to come back from the dead. You sure you're ready for this?
Are you suggesting I'm not?
Just asking the question. I was one of the ones who pulled you out of that mess. Not a memory I want to relive, and I don't have to wake up to the reminder of it every day.
I'm fine.
If you say so. The boss is already on board, arguing with the DPD's tactical response team. They've got the plant surrounded, but Mr. Sarif wants you to go in first. Are you all set here? Because the sooner we take off, the better it will be for everyone.
I'm ready.
Great. Then let's get airborne.
I told Farina to put us down on a roof. I don't want the crowd seeing you go in.
Fine. As long as she pulls you out the minute I'm gone. So what am I looking at here? Who are these guys?
Pro-human purists, or so they say. The same purists who've been firebombing limb clinics all over the country.
You buy that?
Nah, I don't think it's a coincidence they hit us today, only hours after we moved the Typhoon in for assembly line factory.
The Typhoon? Megan's team was testing it the day that bastard... Who's on point for these guys?
Adam, I know you and Megan were once...
Who is on point for these guys?
Goes by the name of Sanders. That's him, there. He's an augmented Adam, so he can't be one of the mercs who attacked us, but he did know exactly how to get inside our plant.
All right, so how do you want me to handle this?
First priority is the Typhoon. I'm keeping SWAT out until you've secured it. As far as rules of engagement go, I'll defer to you. Lethal or non-lethal?
Lethal all the way, man.
I'm not about to take any chances.
Lethal it is. But remember, they do have hostages, and I'd hate to see any of our people get caught in the crossfire. You remember what it's like in there? A lot of tight enclosed hallways, but the labs themselves are pretty open, high ceilings. So, do you want something you can use from a distance?
or up close?
Distance.
Give me something with distance. If I get too close, I'll take them out personally.
Just try not to break anything expensive. The Typhoon should be in the factoring labs, but Pritchard will tell you more as you go in. I've got him running comms.
Terrific. Anything else?
Keep your eyes open for hostages. Free them if you can, but the Typhoon is your number one priority. We developed it for the Alphabet agencies, and if we don't deliver it to them intact and still a secret, well, I'm sure you'll get the job done right.
Gentlemen, prepare for landing.
Whatever, it doesn't matter. Okay, you can zoom in. Yeah, so this type of stuff will happen, like when they start augmenting people and whatnot. But I think that that regardless of what others think and say, and they might say like, we don't want this, blah blah blah, but they will still have it. You know why? Because the first ones that are going to get the benefits are definitely the babies, so that way they can have like less chances at getting diseases and all this stuff, you know. And some people might not want it, like, you know how they're like anti-vax people and all that stuff. So but eventually all of those people will come around to it because there's far too many benefits for them to not have it. So we'll see.
Tell me you're the guy we've been twiddling our thumbs waiting for.
SI Security. Name's Jensen.
Jensen? Yeah. I thought I recognized you. Used to be on Team 2 till that Mexican town thing went down. I gotta say, you're the last person I pictured taking orders from a CEO.
What's up, Bano?
Things change.
Not always for the better. Feel like getting in there and doing whatever it is your boss wants you to do? Because maybe then we can do our job.
I got it from here. Sit tight. Wait for Seraph's signal.
Like we got a choice.
Yeah, I don't want to talk to you. Screw you, man. You suck.
About fucking time. You know there are hostages in there, right?
I know. It's just temporary. Figure I might as well try something different while I'm waiting for the other game to come out. It's gonna be tomorrow.
Jensen, it's me, Pritchard. Where are you?
On a roof overlooking the plant.
Good. Your point of entry should be through shipping and receiving.
Should be, Francis. The hell does that mean?
We have an employee entrance there, heavily guarded by purists, no doubt. So, if you're not a fan of the frontal assault, I suppose you could try accessing the building's roof.
Hey, look, a box drop behind you.
Yo, anyone there?
He knows it. Okay, cool. Noise detection stuff, which is cool.
Game is kind of quiet.
I thought it'd be pretty low, but it's not. Exploration? Secret item? No. Alright. Dude's down. Come and help him.
Someone's gonna pay. You can't escape. Don't hide him.
Well, that was hard. Dude, only 6 bullets is pretty bad. Oh, there's a mini. Oh, well, the minimap isn't actually very important, Vanna. It actually just shows like an X there, and that's it. Like, it's not even like it's yeah. It's pretty useless at the moment. I don't have a sniper rifle though. I thought he was gonna give me a sniper rifle because I said distance, but no. Sorry if I'm not responding quickly, Vanna. I'm kind of tired. Is that like work most of the day? No enemies, huh? Okay. Because I killed them all, so it makes sense, I guess. So this game, if you never played the Deuce EX games, a lot of them have a lot of choices on how you can take each mission. So in my case, I decided to just exploit the dumb AI people and pretty much just kill them all one by one. But I could have come from this side, like I could have come inside this door and looked around, jump on boxes, etc., and could have just gone from here. I could have gone from up top the roof that I was there before, so there's like a lot of options for it, but I chose the lethal route because I was I just wanna, I'm picking the worst options available to me to try to make myself as a bad protagonist.
Bridget, I'm in. The door worked just fine.
I'm happy for you. The Typhoon is in the factoring labs. There's an elevator just past the assembly labs that will take you to it.
Got it.
No, you don't. I'm actually just clicking once, but it's like a burst gun or something. So it just keeps on firing. And that's fine, but... I can search. Okay. Alright. Nope. Not what I meant to do. Am I really? Why would I be nervous though, you know? It doesn't make much sense to me. Let me actually just check it really quick, one sec. So I'm gonna click it once. You're right, I am. I'm trying to burst, I think, is what's going on there. Too used to playing Counter-Strike, you know? Oh, one moment. It's already out. The map has gotten bigger, so might as well just move my camera. And I'll move the chat as well, so that way it doesn't take up the screen. I don't know, some random places. Okay, much better. Let me just make sure that... Okay, all right, sorry. Just doing a couple of adjustments. I'll think of something. I'm sure my microphone lagged there, but I'll think of something to improve the camera stuff as well. Like have like a layout or something for the game, but I'm not sure yet. So when this game first came out, there was a lot of people that were skeptical because this series is pretty good. It's, you know, there have been many, many games and people love them. And it's been around for a long time. So, and when it came out, people didn't actually like it very much. Some people did. I did. But I like most games, so it's not really surprising. let me just see. Here's another way. Okay. Yeah,
You ain't supposed to... Where is the way? I'll be waiting for you, asshole! Keep running, asshole!
Where are
you? Out, you bastard. Where you at?
Okay. That was good. Got a lot of one shots. Oh yeah, this is not Fallout, so there is no like money and gun and stuff inside the toilets. But I gotta check anyways, man. You never know. I'm assuming you never played this, Vanner. I know that Lazarus has never played this. All right, that's too many lockers, man. All right.
Jensen, I just tried to unlock the assembly lab door, but my override codes aren't working. Someone's changed the protocols.
What? Didn't you plug the...
I'm on it. But until I find this particular breach and fix it, you'll have to hack the door manually. Pritchard out.
Okay. Let's hack the door.
Access granted.
Wow, that was so hard. I don't even know what I did there. I just clicked on stuff and it happened. Yeah, I see you too, bro. So you could do what I'm doing, or you could just try to be stealth and all the stuff too. When I play the other game, I'm gonna try to be stealth instead of just running in there and just gunning everything down. By everything, I mean, you know, these people.
Done. I apologize.
Don't just stand there!
Where's the bomb squad?
Hurry!
Wait, did...
Get us out of here! Do something!
Oh, crap. I don't think I'll be able to do this.
Hurry!
Where's the bomb squad?
Get us out of here! Save us!
Where's the bomb squad?
They're dead.
Bastards use gas.
Goodbye.
Poison gas with a time-delayed release.
My god.
I know. Sanders has a lot to answer for.
Well, they're dead. You could save them. I had no idea that was happening, so... it just started ticking and I was like, oh, wait a minute, I can hack this. But I think if I go back, they should all be dead. I'm gonna assume that they're dead. Hell yeah, I killed a hostage, man. I'm a bad person. That's why. Oh. same area? It is. Oh.
Right. Coming in here to dig up shit is fucking gunshots! Oh!
Folks, that this is the second time the biotechnology firm has been attacked. The first time, 6 months ago.
Yeah. That'll hurt somebody, but I guess not. Yeah, I am. Dude, I can't seem to hit that headshot. It's crazy.
Let's finish this! Why making it easy? Come on! Come on!
Where is he? Oh. This is not how you should play this game, by the way. I'm sure that whoever designed the level design and all this stuff is probably like, what are you doing? Don't do this. It's too late, man. Like I said, it's temporary. I don't know how to do this, so.
In order to unlock new abilities or augmentations, you must first gain experience in the form of XP points.
Really?
You will receive these points when completing main objectives, side quests, or through special bonuses, like completing a mission without being detected.
Next time we discuss security loop.
Once you've accumulated enough XP points, you will receive a Praxis point.
Really?
These points are used to unlock upgrades to existing augmentations, and to unlock entirely new augmentations. Praxis kits, which can be found through
I intend to actually to play Grand Theft Auto at some point. I'm just not sure when. All right, so what do I want? No. What that does though. Cooldown timer. I'll go with this. Not really going stealth, but it's something. Not gonna work. I'm sure I have to read something to access that, and not really doing that right now, so. Just need to figure out. Okay, I know how to do it. As I mentioned, there are alternative paths to this, so you can just. I'm just able to skip the turret section there and just go right behind it. I think. Yep. Too heavy.
Step away from the console. Now!
He's gonna shoot himself.
Help me! Son of a bitch. Pritchard, you still there?
Where else would I be?
Patch me to Seraph, now.
Adam, it's David. You got the Typhoon?
Yeah, but you were right about there being something more behind this. Because I've also got a dead purist in here with some pretty interesting cerebral implants.
Don't touch him. We'll need an expert to recover his neural hub. In case it's booby-trapped.
Copy that. What about Sanders?
SWAT's pressuring me to let them off the leash. Find them before they do, and deal with them.
And deal with them. So I'm sure I'm gonna have some type of a choice there. It's probably over here, actually. So that's, like, what happened here? Is one of the scary parts about the future is that, like, the type of companies that will actually, like, progress in those sections, like, if they use it for, you know, if they don't use it for the betterment of mankind and just use it to just own more profits, which has been happening for the past decades, I feel like stuff like this will be very common and whatnot, so yeah, like, it's pretty uncertain. The technology is great, but the people behind it, the people that are leading it, might be the cause of of us not progressing as fast as we should have or could have or would be. But nonetheless, it's a fascinating field. Biochemical engineering and bioengineering. Come on down.
Who's over
there? All right. Great.
Right.
Oh, man. Maybe I should eat something. Can I eat something? Oh, okay, so this is a different gun, I guess. No, never mind. Okay, that was a weird bug then, I guess.
But sources tell me that a militant group of pro-human activists have raided a Seraph Industries plant. Factory workers have been taken hostage.
I mean, we already have a technology in which we can actually just have, like, devices that are literally just like paper, and they would just transmit the screen or whatever, you know? Cool. It is there. Just. It doesn't have any money in it, so I'm sure they're thinking of ways to say, how do we profit from this? Man, that guy came in, he's like, whoa, you're killing the hostages, and then he just left. He was like, this guy's no good. What's the difference between these? Nope, no difference. Okay.
Convincing people you're any different once they hear you had an AUG on your team.
What?
I found your attack dog in the factoring labs, trying to cut through security with his implanted hackware.
Nice try, Cholo. But I would never let one of you freaks on my crew. Back off, Lantern! I got business to take care of, understand? If what you say is true, and I'm not saying it is, we're here, but I gotta check things out. So me and La Vieja, we're leaving.
Not a chance this ends now.
Her blood is on your hands!
Kill me! Kill me! Okay, yep. You can do it. Yep.
I'm gonna rip your phony heart out!
Very close now. Almost there. Yep. One more shot. Just. Okay. All right. No. Don't shoot at the legs. Head. Nope. There you go. Okay. I'm sure it's gonna load me like right next to it. Okay. Maybe not. Hey, it's kind of close.
Don't lie to me.
Not a chance this ends now.
Adam! Adam, what's happening? What's your situation? Adam!
Sanders is dead, but he didn't know about the AUG or the Typhoon. Somebody else set this up.
Damn it. Okay, I want you back here now. The admin building has a rooftop terrace. Meet Verita on it.
Copy. Jensen out.
So, when this game first came out, I actually tried shooting these guys, but they're like really, really strong and they killed me every time. So it's not actually worth doing that. I wonder if I can just shoot her.
I see you!
No! Wow, I did it. Okay, everyone's dead. Mission accomplished. Did I shoot you too? Okay. Flashbang. How do I even throw flashbangs? Alright. Oh.
Not quite what you signed up for, is it, Jensen?
Excuse me?
Sneaking into your own factory to hide stuff while the boss holds the cops at bay? Don't get me wrong, I love Mr. Seraph. I just hate it when contracts become more important than people. I thought you did too.
Sorry to break it to you, Malik, but that's just the way the world is.
Doesn't mean I have to like it. You ready to go?
Yeah, get me out of here, Malik.
Your wish is my command. Climb in.
There were a couple of choices and places where that scenario could have gone. I think the worst possible option. In which, like, I actually saved a lady and then I shot her by myself, so. Yeah.
New orders just in, Jensen. The boss wants Pritchard to examine the Typhoon ASAP.
Copy that. Thanks for the lift.
No problem. Hey, and Jensen, I just wanted to say, new look suits you. Like, you haven't missed a beat at all.
Thanks.
So, how's it feel? Being augmented.
Excuse me?
Don't take it the wrong way. I mean, I've got a few neuro enhancements myself. Discreet ones to help me fly better. But I chose to get them implanted. You didn't. Now that you had a chance to try him out, what do you think?
I didn't choose the augmented life. The augmented life chose me.
I'm not gonna lie and say they didn't come in handy back there. But like you said, I didn't choose to get augmented.
So it'll take some getting used to. I get it. But don't be surprised if the boss keeps pushing you to get more.
Why? What do you mean?
You know how he is. He thinks augmentations are the be-all, end-all of everything. And he can't understand why someone wouldn't want to become more than human.
Megan used to say the same thing.
I'm not surprised. The research she was doing was pretty damn inspired. Might have convinced a lot more people to give what we make here a try. If
that bastard hadn't killed her.
Listen, Jensen. I know you want to find the men who attacked us, and so do I. If I can help in any way, all you gotta do is ask.
Actually, there is something. I want to know about the first attack.
Fine. Ask away.
I'm gonna find them, Malik. One way or another.
I believe you. And just so you know, when you do, I've got your back.
I appreciate that, Malik, but right now...
You've got to get the Typhoon into the tech lab, right. See you later, then. Oh, and Jensen, the boss wants a face-to-face debrief in his office once it's secure.
Roger that. Good night, Malik.
All right. That was an interesting exchange. Don't play this game like this, man. It's not... Yeah, it just doesn't work out well. What's up, guys?
Talks all over the office, Mr. J. You really took care of those Purity First assholes. Wish I could have been there to see it.
Hey, boss. I hear that Milwaukee Junction deal got really messy. Lots of body bags? Kinda a shame, don't you think?
No, man, not at all. Can't shoot you, but not at all, man.
So. We've been hearing rumors here. The leader of the terrorists. I think it's disgusting how public opinion has turned on David so quickly. Like it's him.
I mean, if I had the choice of being augmented, I would 100% go. Especially if there were no, like, super duper bad side effects, you know?
Well, well, if it isn't Attila the Hun, fresh from the killing fields. If this is about the Typhoon, I'll get to it in a minute.
Now, Pritchard. I didn't risk my neck to have you lose it in a pile of CPUs and scuzzy adapters.
Well, look at you, using the big words. Don't think just because you hacked through the plant security system so fast that you're an expert on everything computer. There's a reason I can't examine the Typhoon yet.
Do tell.
For your information, I am running a diagnostic sweep on our network and router security to find out how Sanders' hacker got a hold of our codes.
I'd have thought the first question to ask is, whose codes were they? Unless you already know.
Stick to kicking down doors and shooting people, Jensen, and stop trying to do my job. I guarantee you we'll get along better that way.
Okay.
What do you think they talk about?
David and you, Darrow? Hell if I know. What did Bill Gates and Steve Jobs talk about?
I bet he's trying to convince him to come out of hiding and make a statement that will counteract Bill Taggart.
Darrow is not hiding. He's working day and night in the Arctic, trying to save the world. It's what millionaires do when they get bored. They save the world. Didn't you know that?
Yeah. Sure.
Right. I'll see you.
Some good stuff.
I'm telling you, Hugh, he might not have put the gun in Sanders' hand, but it was Taggart's speech to the UN that started all this.
William Taggart is nothing if not a shrewd political operator. You know that, David.
So for the sake of appearances, I have to look him in the eye and let him bullshit me?
With a smile. Always with a smile. We'll talk later.
To see me?
Yeah, how you feeling?
I've had better days.
Well, when we're done here, check him at Dr. Markovic at the Limb Clinic downtown. Can't hurt to get a checkup.
If you insist. Listen, about Sanders?
You did what you had to do, son. As far as I'm concerned, Sanders got what he deserved. So don't start second-guessing yourself.
I'm not. But that's not why I brought him up. Sanders was tricked into attacking us. By the hacker I caught going after the Typhoon.
He's the man we really needed to interrogate today.
Exactly. Only he killed himself to prevent any chance of my doing that. That takes real dedication.
Yeah, or training. You're sure he was augmented?
I pulled his cables out myself.
Yeah, well, the police are saying he's not, and they're refusing to let me see the body. no matter how much money I threaten to pull from their retirement fund.
Well, maybe they didn't like being held off so long at the plant.
Is that my head of security speaking? Or the ex-cop? Listen, Adam, I don't want to squabble about this. I need you to get to the bottom of it. You still got friends on the force. You think one of them will let you into the morgue?
Depends who I run into.
Get over to the station and find a way inside. Because if that hacker was augmented, his neural hub might tell us who he was. Contact me when you've gotten a hold of it.
Boss, what you're asking me to do, it's not exactly legal.
No, it isn't. You got a problem with that?
As a matter of fact, I do.
Look, Adam. You know the police never fully investigated that first attack, don't you?
Yes, but...
But nothing. We lost a lot of good people, top people. And I'm beginning to think Detroit PD doesn't give a damn. Someone is pulling strings to keep us in the dark.
And in your world, the ends justify the means.
My world is your world, Adam. And if getting that neural hub illegally will show us who's behind these attacks, and maybe even help us go after them, yeah, you're damn right it does. So get going.
All right. It's kind of funny to just see the dialogue and stuff that they made to piss people off. It's entertaining. So I'm actually just gonna end it here soon. I just want to show you the outside play. So if you intend on playing this game at some point in the near future, it's pretty good. And like I said, like, don't play it like I've been playing it. It's not. That's not what these games are about.
Adam Jensen.
But yeah, I'm not gonna actually go to the office because I'm sure there's some other side quest stuff, I think. So pretty much you go through this introductory stuff and then you end up here.
Mrs. Reed?
Adam, I'm sorry you startled me. And please, call me Cassandra. You and Megan were together long enough. I was waiting for you.
Out here? Why not come meet me inside?
I don't know. I guess I'm just not ready. This is where you work, but to me, this is also the place where I lost my daughter.
I try not to think about it.
Oh. Well, I guess it's the sensible thing to do. I just don't know if I'd be able to. But then again, after what you've been through...
Yeah. A lot of things changed 6 months ago.
I can't get over how much they've changed you. At first, I couldn't even believe you were still alive. How do you handle all of this?
Never asked the augmented life. Wait, sorry. I never chose the augmented life. The augmented life chose me.
I never asked for this. They say they saved me, but I'm not sure saved is the right word.
I understand your anger. I wouldn't take too kindly to people making that kind of decision for me, either. But that being said, I for one am glad that you're still among us.
Can I ask why you wanted to see me?
Yes, of course. I'm sorry. I'm here about Megan. About what happened to her. Or rather, about the investigation into what happened.
What about it?
Well, simply put, I feel something is not quite right with the way the case was handled.
You think there was some foul play involved?
I do. Call it mother's intuition. But when speaking to some of the investigators, there were a lot of inconsistencies. And then I met this detective, a man called Chase. He agreed things weren't handled by the book, although he has no proof.
And now you want to find out more?
I'll never hear my daughter laugh again, Adam. I'll never get a call from her to ask how I've been, or have the chance to ask her about her day. She was stolen from me. However unjustified this all is, I still want to know why it happened. You're not the same, Adam. And we've yet to see if it's for better or worse. But I know you loved Megan. Please, will you help me find out what really happened to her?
I'm sorry. I can't right now.
Oh. Well, I understand. But I'm afraid you're the only one who can help me. I'll stay here for a while. Please come find me if you change your mind.
Okay, so you can investigate that, investigate the murder, and you can also go take calls in your office and all this stuff whenever this icon is here. I think this is for side quests. I don't actually remember. You can talk to these people.
I'm sorry. I really can't talk right now, Mr. Jensen. See? I'm still in shock.
Can also throw a flashbang. Okay, that's probably not a flashbang. I think that dude's dead. Oh, he's sleeping. Okay. Well, I didn't. Oh shit. Hopefully nobody sees them. But yeah, basically you just go around the city and then you start doing quests, and then there's just a lot of it's a pretty fun game. I recommend it, and like I said multiple times. Hey babe. That just don't play like me. Like how I played here. Okay, they're about to investigate the murder of that guy.
Ah.
So they have no idea who did this, which is why they're actually not just attacking me immediately.
What the hell was that?
I never asked for this. And you can also melee them and like stuff too if you go into stealth or whatever, but I'm not gonna do that. But pretty much that's it. That is how these games are like. You're basically doing missions. You have a lot of choices. Like you can do it stealthily, or you could go combat heavy and just shoot them in the head and get it over with. You could use your augmentative abilities to try to make your combat look cool, or you could be like how I played, where I just played it very dully and just shot one guy, waited until the other guy came, shot him in the head, and just kept on shooting them until there were no more. So, but what's interesting about these games is the premise of it, and basically like these augmentations and things like that are pretty cool. So with that said, I am done. So thank you for watching, and I will not be continuing this game. Tomorrow night I'll be able to start up the new game. I believe it's Mankind Divided. Or Man Divided or something. So, thank you. And I hope this was informative. And Street Quest. Services are temporarily offline. Thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.